The best boxing movie franchise of all time is celebrating its 45th anniversary on November 21st. Of course, I'm talking about Sylvester Stallone's Rocky movie franchise. Hindi naman sigurong obvious na big fan ako ng Rocky. Well, the film series, which grossed more than $1.7 billion at the worldwide box office, produced 6 original installments and 2 spin-offs. Tonight on Round by Round, we will go through Bill Velasco's top 5 Rocky movies.
Parang ako yung sisisihin ah.
Well, malalaman natin yan. Ngayon, at number 5, Rocky 3. The movie was released in May 1982. It's known for popularizing Survivor's Eye of the Tiger. Bill, why did you put Rocky 3 at number 5?
Well, a lot of things happened to the character in this movie. Mm-hmm. Unang-una, you know, they started killing off some of the major characters.
Yeah, Mickey Goldmill.
Rocky alone. Yeah. By you know, to face all these major challenges. Secondly, the pure entertainment value of this film. First of all, you have a Mr. T trying to look serious. This was after I think Stallone experimented with Ernie Shavers and realized that he would have gotten killed in the ring with Ernie Shavers, one of the hardest hitting heavyweights. And then also the Thunderlips scenario, which was basically inspired by an undercard fight featuring Andre the Giant in the Ali Inoki event. Yeah. So Hulk Hogan, of course, a big figure back in the 80s. But at this point in time, paangat pa lang si Hulk Hogan.
Yeah.
Again, it's very entertaining. A lot happened to the character. It was more of a transition because the first two installments were sort of like, you know, parenthetical because they closed out the first story arc for Rocky. What would happen next? And inevitably, the stories would get sillier and sillier. Pero at this point in time, medyo maganda-ganda pa yung story.
Fun fact, Hulk Hogan got fired from the WWF because of Rocky 3. At number 4, Rocky 2. The movie was released in June 1979. The installment is described as Rocky's redemption arc. Bill, what are your favorite moments during in this film? Because sa akin, ang favorite moment ko dito was the running scene where, alam mo yan, with a bunch of kids. Hindi ko alam para na pull up ni Sylvester Stallone yan, but that's the iconic scene in that film. Aside from the, "Yo, Adrian, I did it!"
Yeah, you know, let's try to remember that the first movie was an unfinished story. All right, you know, if that were a Filipino movie, he would have won the World Heavyweight Championship at the end of that movie, you know, which would not have made sense.
Yeah.
This one, again, he gets better. He finally overcomes Apollo Creed. He evolves as a person, but also, technologically speaking, the film is much better. You know, when you look at the number of shots they used in all of the boxing sequences, it's more than double what they did in the first movie. So. Yeah. Technologically, it's a superior film. The writing is not as solid as the first film, but it takes the characters further. It's also more dramatic, you know. And there's still that uncertainty of whether he can really beat a really polished master of disaster in Apollo Creed. Fun fact: when Muhammad Ali first heard the line "master of disaster," he said, "I wish I'd thought of that." but again, very entertaining movie. You know, very dramatic. We always wanted to see what happened to the character next after the first film, because it was very potent, and the first film won an Oscar. So, you know, this was not quite up to that standard in terms of the substance of the film, but in terms of the form and how it was executed, much better.
Next on the list at number 3, Creed, the first spin-off in the Rocky movie franchise that was released in November 2015. Bill, this spin-off, Creed, had a refreshing and modern take, but I'm quite surprised that you didn't pick Creed 2.
Well, for me, Creed 2 was more of, you know, the results of Creed 2 are more of pagbigyan si Sly Stallone. No, he got the Golden Globe. We were hoping he'd get an Oscar, and he didn't.
Yeah.
But for me, it's more of this is the starting point of a new branch of the story. And Michael B. Jordan always adds so much intensity whenever he's in a film. No, if you don't include Fantastic Four. aside from that, for Sylvester Stallone, remember Rocky Balboa? Yeah. I thought that if that were the end of the franchise, I would have felt so bad because it was really a shame.
Yeah.
You know, a world heavyweight champion fighting a 60-year-old. It did not make sense.
Yeah.
It might have been a cash grab at some point. And remember, Stallone's even older than the character in real life. So it really looked bad. So for this to start a fresh new chapter in the Rocky story, for me, made very perfect sense. It was also a way of him adapting to modern times, say for chasing chickens. and, you know, again, you're adding new blood in Michael B. Jordan and all the other surrounding characters. Kaya maganda yung pagkahalo, di ba, ng bagong lasa dun sa dati ng menu na alam natin. So for me, that's why it's in the middle of my list.
At number two, Rocky. Of course, the original, the one that started it all. Also, this movie won Best Pictures at the Oscar. Bill, it must be the glass of raw eggs that made you put this movie to number two.
Oh, pero dito sa Pilipinas, sinahaluan natin na SARS.
Yeah, totoo.
Ang RC Cola. Diba? Yung hilaw na itlog. It's also the backstory of what Stallone went through. Remember, sinanlaan yung aso niya. They were filming in Philadelphia in winter and their dressing rooms were just 4 pieces of plywood nailed together, you know, with no top. And so they went through a lot of suffering, a lot of discomfort. The budget was very, very low, ridiculously low, and it performed so well and came away with an Oscar. And that, I think, was what established Sylvester Stallone as not just an actor, but a writer. Remember, they were recommending so many different actors to play the lead. He insisted to play Rocky himself. And that is not easy to do in Hollywood. So for whatever, you know, this film went through and for it to reach the heights that it reached, and there's not much tinkering you can do with the story.
Yeah.
You know, it's really practically set in stone. It's the mythos of Rocky. Kaya para sa akin, napaka laking bagay ito na it really propelled Stallone's career when you think about it. No, he got to do Rambo. He tried to do some action comedies. He started producing his own films. And you know, at what, 75, 76 years old, he's still doing movies. They're filming Expendables 4. This started it all. And if not for this film, we wouldn't even be having this conversation 45 years.
Yeah. At number one, Rocky 4. It's hands down the best among the bunch. It was released in November 1985. It's the only Rocky movie that didn't feature Bill Conti's signature musical score for the franchise. Fortunately, Vince DiCola did a tremendous job with its musical score. Rocky IV also gave birth to his fiercest rival, Ivan Drago. Bill, I don't need to know why it's at the top of your list, but I would like to know, how excited are you to see the director's cut of this film?
I've been waiting for a couple of months now to see it because for Sylvester Stallone to pick this film overall, it really encapsulated the era. Okay, the USSR was this big, you know, mystical, mysterious monster that always seemed to be against the United States, and the tables were turned. Now they were technologically and scientifically superior. Yeah. Now their athletes were bigger and stronger, and they're taking some shortcuts with some injectables back at that time. And Stallone went back to his roots in this film, just raw, gutting it out in training every day. So the contrasts were very nice. And for them to have a Mikhail Gorbachev look-alike,
yeah, you
know, in the film. I actually had a college classmate from Canada who was an extra in this film. And he talked about how challenging it was, how they had to keep track of everything, especially when they're doing the fight sequences. And Dolph Lundgren also got catapulted to fame after this. The Punisher, he did a lot of other, he did He-Man, if you are willing to talk about that. and the contrast, the black hats versus the white tails, it's really, everything here is clear cut. You know, who's the bad, and of course, Bridget Nielsen, who became Mrs. Stallone in the, after presenting herself to Sly.
In a few years, and after a few years, and then they...
Yeah. She ain't not legal, actually, kay Sly.
Yeah.
And then they did Cobra together. So, for me, this is a snapshot of that era, which people might have forgotten. Because back in the day, in a lot of different sports, Soviet athletes would play professionally, then declare themselves amateur, and then go back into the Olympics. Because at the time, there were no professional athletes allowed in the Olympic Games. They did this in basketball, in hockey, and in a lot of other sports. So this is, you know, where you're really rooting for Rocky. You know, he's in foreign territory. Again, it's the next story arc already. Where does he go from winning an All-American world heavyweight championship? And it's very, it's a good evolution. Of course, they took a few liberties. It's kind of extreme to have the leader of the USSR actually be there to watch the fight. But, you know, and in fact, Stallone actually trimmed down for this fight, so he would look even smaller compared to Ivan Drago.
4% body fat.
Yeah. He's lucky he didn't get, you know, cramps during the filming. But, you know, maganda, maganda yung pagkagawa. In fact, if they had ended the series there, I would have been perfectly happy.
Bill, happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary, Sly Stallone.